RapidMiner Server requires a database in which it can store repositories, including files and process, and also its configuration files and system table. Since version 7.2, RapidMiner Server requires Java 8. So we'll now start with installing Java, and then we'll configure our database. We've pre-installed a blank Oracle 11g Express here and also set up SQL Developer, so in case you want to follow along, you should pause the video now and do the same. You can see the installer file for Java available here, which you can download freely from Oracle. We'll start the installation by using the right mouse button option so we can install it as administrator. In case you're wondering, we'll explain in the server installation part why we're using the JDK and not the JRE executable, even though both are supported. Note that only the Oracle Java packages are supported for RapidMiner Server. You can keep the default Java destination folder or change it, but make sure to remember where you put it, as you'll need the information during the server installation. While the installation of Java is completing, we can now turn to the database part. We recommend to use either Oracle, Microsoft SQL, PostgreSQL, or MySQL for the RapidMiner Server schema. Note that for MySQL, in case you run it on a Windows machine, you will need to also download the JDBC driver and make sure to set up Microsoft's Visual C++ 2013 and 2015 redistributables, as well as the Visual Studio Tools for Office runtime. Now let's set up our database schema and a user. Depending on which database type you use, we recommend a separate schema, tablespace, or database. This helps set permissions for the database user, as well as keep things better organized. In Oracle, we'll set up a new tablespace, which we can do using the DBA view in SQL Developer. But first, we need to establish a connection from our SQL Developer to the database, which we can do here. We'll call the connection system, as we're using the system user. Now, in the DBA view, we add the connection and then expand system and then the storage subsection. With the right mouse button, we can now select to create a new tablespace. You're free to choose any name, but don't use lower or mixed case. We'll make this a permanent space, and as database file name, we will use rm.dbf. Let's start with 100 megabytes, but we'll not limit the size. Everything else can be kept as default. Now, to create our user, we can use the connections view, expand it, and scroll down to other users. Again, with right mouse button, you can select create user. This user is used to connect RapidMiner Server to the database. Therefore, we will call the user rmdbuser. We'll switch the user's default tablespace to the one we just created. To save time in the demo, we'll just grant all roles and privileges to our user. Finally, we allow the user to use our entire tablespace and hit apply. You can ignore the error if you're using the same simple approach as we do here. When you check the users listed, you can now see your new user, and it has most of what we assigned, which is more than needed. Now, with this all set, we can proceed to installing RapidMiner Server. Thank you very much for watching.